Alrighty, everyone. Let's see if this really double. No, I'm gonna mute that because I don't need that. I don't need two microphones. So today we're going to. Why is that not moving? Why is this video capture device not moving? For me. Well. This one is not, for some reason. Interesting, this is going to be fun. Let's take it out and put it back. See if that works. That kind of works. And, oh, yes. Cool. Make it fit. And then we'll drop it down below here because I have a second camera. I have a second closer camera, so this way, yeah, you can play with stuff. And because I'm going to be working on small things. I'd rather have a small camera. Real close. Okie dokie. So, we have an old pair of Dell speakers that fit underneath a monitor, and we're going to go ahead and take them, and we're going to make them useful for something fun. Okay, put that there. As soon as that slow-ass camera figures it out. So there we have a dollar store. There. Dollar store USB charger. 12 volt to 5 volt. And on the inside of this guy, before I decided to record this, there were two screw holes. Up top. Nope. Let's move this out of the way. Okay. So, on the top of this guy, we had two screw holes. One up top here, and one below where the wire is coming out of. Now, this one didn't have a screw in it, so that's kind of nice. But it didn't have a screw. So I was able to cut behind this and jam the wire out of it after much drilling and cursing and yelling at it, but it worked. And what I did instead of my usual connect to the actual metal here, instead of connecting to the metal here, what I did was on the board that's inside of here, I went on the underside and soldered to the positive and negative. Put it back together. Bob's your uncle. This guy actually has some pretty good strain relief on him, so there was no need to add strain relief. So on with it.
Oh no.
And my apologies for the random yelling. The little one decided he didn't want to listen to me today. So, the large, gross bits jam the stupid cable up through. And for this, I'm actually going to tie a knot in it. Quick, simple, tie knot. And that will be my strain relief. But I want this knot to be down a little lower, so I have more to play with. Because once this thing gets back together, I'm not hoping not to be able, not to have to take it apart again. I probably should grab a drink on my way down, but que sera. So, scissors, where's the multi-tool? I had it. on my lap. And of course, I'm completely utterly unprepared for my video here. But that's just me. Oh, there's my multi-tool. I'm gonna need him too. Now as you can see the big black fucking mark on the paper here. That is actually plastic dip, which I made a 16-foot USB cable last night. I just decided, you know what, I'm not waiting 8 weeks for that. I actually may make a video of me making a USB gender changer. That might be fun. Because the cord that I'd made, I've spaced and made a USB A to A cord. Basically, it has the two pokey bits. The two ends. Trash box. It has the two ends that plug into a USB port, instead of the end that plugs into a device and a port. Oh well, I was tired. It was like 1 o'clock when I made that stupid thing. So, strip of the wires a little bit. There we go. And now, here comes the fun. Oh my god. Really? I've been sitting here talking the entire time. Noise gate and suppression is there. I've been talking the entire freaking time, and, you know, it wasn't recording. Oh well. Fun stuff. But you don't get to hear my son yelling as much. then. So we grab the 100-pound sledgehammer to do this work. And grab these. Now this here is the front of the board. And we have our two bits here. Okay, you go down there. Which is why I kind of like this desk. I can push things through if I need to, get them down a little lower. So I can work on them. And yep, he just doesn't stop. You tell him to shut up because you're recording a video. You tell him... Oh, hang on a second. You tell him to shut up because you're recording a video. And he just doesn't listen. Huh? Huh, nothing. So. Hopefully that has solved that problem. And we'll get these wires in here. Of course I've got them coming from the wrong direction. There we go. Now on the other side of the board here, which is neat because it has a QR code. On the other side of the board here, right behind these two capacitors that are in the way of the camera, we have our two pads here. One's 12 volt, one's ground. So this is 12 volt one, and this is the ground one. And yes, I know the frame rate's low, that's because it's a IP camera. So the wireless is going slow because people are using it. And I'm not worried about that. So 12 volts ground. Time for the 100 watt sledgehammer. And then once I'm done, I'm going to throw a little ball of solder. I'll just use what I put there already. Like a little Hershey Kiss. Yeah, I know, that's probably all you engineering folks are probably like, what the fuck, man? Really? What's he doing messing that thing up like that? So, I'm going to do one thing I should never do. You should never do is put a soldering iron in your lap. But that might make things exciting, so that is what I shall do. Is put the soldering iron in my lap. And of course, I don't have the normal tools to do this. I'm just some nut doing what I do. I like to play with this shit. Okay, come on. There. Usually I'd have some tunes going, but this time, nah. Oh, balls. You see, fun stuff like that happens. Where you soldered the end of the wire, but not the part you actually wanted to solder. That's okay. You know what, I probably should move the camera that's watching this over to here so it can get a good view of what the freak I'm doing. Now, I'm not going to tell you why I'm doing it. I just like to do it. I like to take things that are broken, or that people say are broken, and I fix them. Or make them better. In some way. Oh. Just gotta watch out for that. Oh. I just have to cut this off. Because that turned into a wrangled old mess. Rancid old mess. Okay. They put that there to kind of put... That does absolutely fucking nothing. The goggles, they do nothing. So, okay. I'm going to hold it there then. With the multi-tool. Pliers. And yeah, I do have a whole crap load of solder on this. Burnt myself. That was fun. Nice. Yeah, I know you're not supposed to cut your solder joints, but I don't give a fuck. Okay. It's gotten quieter in here. The heater's gone off. That makes me extremely happy. That the heater is now fucked off. Okay, and this one I'm gonna cut prematurely. Go. Off into the abyss it goes. And... where you at? So there's definitely enough solder on in here. Yeah, I'm sorry. Well, if you guys donate when I get donations up, then I can get a better camera for the smaller work. Or maybe even a head-mounted camera so you guys can see what the hell I see. Which would actually be pretty cool. Man, I hear this thing through the headphones. Noisy as all hell. And I missed. Got some of it. Some of that ground wire, but not all of it. Wow. Just the low hum from these. From this soldering iron is hilariously. There we go. Yeah, every time I bring it closer to the mic or the headphones, I hear a... No, you guys can't hear that. It's like a 60 hertz hum. Most people actually can't hear it, or they ignore it. Drives me fucking batty. We've got those attached to the board. Let's clean it up and make sure there are no shorts. Because shorts would suck at this point in time. Yep, there's a short there. There. So we've got Yeah. Focus, focus, focus. So 2x. Hopefully. Oh, you can't see bloody crap. Let's go for the autofocus hold. And yeah. All right, come on, focus. There we go. So that's what we've got so far. It's two wires, bing bang, put together. Snip. Snip. And I don't like the look of that, so we get our happy friend. Oh, hang a second. That does not do well. Get our happy friend plastic coat. And look at that. That looks pretty neat up there, over there. I may do this live sometimes. I may not. So, plastic coat, plastic dip. Yeah. Basically, liquid electrical tape. May the Schwartz be with you. I hope it doesn't fucking. Hence the piece of paper. Because I change out a piece of paper real easy, I can't change out the surface of a desk as easily. So we'll put that away. I'll bring this back up, bring the levels back up. And give that a couple minutes to set up before we move on to the next section. Yeah, it looks like a big old turd stain on there, doesn't it? Yeah, I like that. Looks like a big old friggin' turd stain. Let's go for properties and let's turn. No, not play with that. So, well, I'm waiting for it to set up at least. Filters. What effect filters can I put on audio? Video filters, okay. That's audio video filters effects. Ooh, cool. Maybe I can get rid of those black bars. No, that's not working. That's not working either. One. Nope, that does not work. Ew. None. Okay, so that does not work. Scaling aspect ratio does not work. One second. Let's see if we could sharpen it a little bit. That'd be kind of neat. Especially when I zoom in. Okay, that's cool. Crop and pad. Okay, so I have to crop up the bottom. Whoa. No, that's not working. So I want the whole thing. Oh well. I guess sharpen it is then, so it's gonna sharpen that picture up a little bit. I mean it's the camera itself is doing 1080 by 1440. And it's why you see the bars. Yeah, this is the worst part. Wait, the waiting. And where in the hell did that SMD fucking doohickey go? Little green LED I was gonna use. It's probably on the paper still. Yes, there it is. Is super small. And I'm going to put it onto this board. Yeah, am actually going to plastic dip the I'm going to plastic coat the entire bottom of the board so this way it doesn't short out because it's going to be in a mobile application. And I don't like the stuff that I build to blow up. Actually, may rework my wife's and do the same thing. Soldering the things directly to the board, say using the existing wires, because, it's kind of ghetto hack. Putting the wires into it is a little better. At least the power wire. Doody doody do. Maybe dry enough for us to work with. But I wanted those pads covered so this way, if something does happen, then. If something does move in it and tries to cause a short, it won't. So. We then move on to this guy. Multi-tool. There you are. And so for this, we are going to do something actually a little special. And I'm going to don't see why they felt the need to insulate the legs of this stupid thing. But they did. And let's see if I get a little more zoom in on this. 281? Maybe? Maybe 3. 3x? No. A little further. All right, 4x. That sharpened's actually working pretty decently. Let me get the focus set. So now I'll flip this down, and we see the Bobo LED. And for some reason, they decided to insulate the legs. That's cute of them. So here I come to snip your freaking legs, cut you off at the knees. Only thing that was left was the insulation. So noting that the use friggin' Celastic over here too. That's gonna be fun. Do the longer of the two is negative. It's the shorter on this, but the longer of the two there. So we take our LED, which is up there on my keyboard. But first, we have to flow some solder on this thing. Because it's not going to stick unless it's that way. See if I can get the. Hey! Bonus! Off to the trash bin you go. And this one, off to the trash bin you go. Now we have happy. Happy happiness. And. Longer two is negative, so on the right hand side we have the positive. Or my left is the negative. On your right, it's the positive. Yeah, so you guys can't see me getting cancer. Okay, tip teeny. Teeny tip. Deal. Yes, I know I'm shorting it. As long as I don't pop those capacitors, I'm happy. Okay. That actually should be enough for the SMD. And I dropped my solder. Now here's the trick to get this SMD on those legs. Freaking dropped it. no matter. Okay, soldering iron in a safe spot. Eeny, meeny, miny, moe, where'd you freaking go? There you are. Nope, missed. There we go. I actually kind of like this because I really need the light. I can come over here and kick a light on. Okay, slide this back towards me so I can work on it. And the multi-tool. I gotta get right. The longer of the two is negative, so that's the anvil. Anvil. Now, what I did was I went and I went to the dollar store, get something neat and lady. They're You're kidding me. Oh well. You guys can hear me, and I am sorry about that insane noise, but I live with it every day. Which is why I hate winter, but I love it at the same time because it's about 53 down here. Is a beautiful temperature. Yeah, you guys can see the shadow from the thingy. So I can see quite well. Fucking hot snot. Okay, that and the anvil. And then the career begins because I'm going to put the SMD here. This is like totally not the way to do this, but SMD there. And that there. Is this even on camera? Almost. Yeah, you guys can see the SMD on the jaws of the pliers there. And then I just have to... There we go. And... Yeah, you guys saw that, right? That's funny. That's actually pretty funny. But the nature of the setup I have... I go with this bad boy up, and there it is. About to fly off the freaking paper. But the plastic dip kept it from doing that. I would love to be able to remove this board from the plastic and junk and crap. I was able to remove the speakers, which is a good thing. Less bulk to play with. So, right there. There we go. Okay, SMD, come here, you. Surface mount diodes. Oh. Yeah, feel free to cue the Benny Hill music at any time right now. Because... I wish I had another tripod for the other camera. I'm going to turn that flashlight off because it is a pain in my ass. It is swamping me out. Okay, so soldering iron for when I actually grab the damn thing. And I'm going to bring this up close. Super small LED. Maybe if I lay it on top. If I kick this back like that and lay it on top and then just kind of hit it with the soldering iron, hopefully don't kill the phosphor. And then afterwards I will test the LED to make sure that it is soldered correctly to do its job. Because these right here are the two legs for it. No, don't rotate, you stupid thing. I just want you to move back a little bit. And... that is magnetized. Fuck. Most of my stuff is magnetized. Which makes things great, but when I'm playing with stuff like this, in these little circumstances, it doesn't work well. So, okay. Make sure you keep the polarity right. Okay, so we'll take a look at this SMD real fast. Surface mount diode. Let me... have it focus here. I have not fired up the soldering iron in a while, so let's see. Zoom. I've been trying to get some good macro shots with it with my phone here, but it doesn't work. So you can kind of see on. Well, focus. Okay. Maybe if I pull it back a little bit, you might be able to see. Okay, yeah. If I pull it back a little bit, you can see a little better. We're on this side here. It's a little thinner. Oh, look at that. That's beautiful. That's beautiful. I gotta... Oh, man, really? Okay. That's actually a pretty cool macro shot right there. Come on. You stupid bastard thing. It had a nice thing and didn't. Okay, so we can see on the other side then. On the left-hand side here. Right-hand side, whatever side. But you can see there's a bit more metal on this side over here than there is on this side. Focus, you goddamn it! I really wish this had manual focus, but, you know, beggars can't be choosers, and I'm setting stuff up just on a whim. Okay, so let's see if I can get it to focus. And as soon as it does, I'm kicking the autofocus hold. Because it's focusing more on my shirt than it is the object I want it to focus on. Hey, autofocus hold. There we go. We can see that thing now. That's beautiful. That is a beautiful shot of that right there. So we can see the larger side. 1 second, please. Okay, sorry about that. Had to send the little one up. The young one. Not the little one. The young one. Okay, so surface mount LED. And I've taken it out of the shot. Completely. I'm learning how to move. Because I'm looking at it while I'm... Hey! Okay, whatever. So we've got the smaller side over this side, towards the end of the pliers, and that is going to be our positive side. And the negative side is the anvil. If you look at a regular LED, the anvil, and all that wonderful stuff. Okay. So we bring this up, place the diode right there, right there, and push it towards that. And, you know, sometimes this takes three or four hands. And the one YouTuber that I love watching, an electrical engineer, great guy, Big Clive, he's... oh my goodness. He's been doing this for way too long and can solder four-handed with just one. Okay, and this is going to be fun. All I have to do is melt this a little bit for it to... stick to the... Yeah, you guys could see that. So, I've pushed it out of the way. And my thing is not focusing. There. It's focusing on my stomach. I love it. I absolutely love it.
Yeah, I need a fixed focus camera. Okay. Now, that side's done. I hope. Hooray! Success. SMD now has legs.
Service mount diode now has legs.
Cool.
Let's see. And this is a 45-minute video on just two wires and an LED. Oh, well, I solder slowly. Okay. I put it up there, and handiwork. But the best is yet to come. We get this guy here, and balls. Okay.
Now, there is about a 16th of an inch gap on the back of this LED. Then I'm just going to have to kind of push. Balls. Balls. Oh, that is good. That's got to be my catchphrase or something, really. But I think I've got it. That's not pretty. I don't like it. So I'm going to use the solder that's already on my gun. Now you guys can see it ain't pretty.
It ain't. Come on, focus. There you go. It ain't pretty. This bit.
But if I go and do this,
actually looks a bit better.
Now, shall we test it with a coin cell? I think we should. And my coin cells have disappeared because my son was at my desk and has no respect for where my shit goes. One coin cell stays. Oh!
No, those are 1.5s. Wait, nope, there is my coin cell.
Let's switch to the larger scene. And I will zoom out the what's the name camera?
Bellicam.
Okay. So I keep a little, actually it's a wireless charger. I keep that with, because it's got magnets in it. Parts. Holding the parts. So, great thing is, I can take the coin cell. I'm not going to worry about that. I'm not going to worry about the springs. Spring my thing. Hit coin cell, go. Because it's used to 3 volts. Let's see if this bad boy lights. Fucking back volt it. Yep.
There and there. No, he does not like. So, we grab the bag of shit parts. Bag of recovered parts, more like it. That is my braid. My impromptu braid. Okay, so we're going to test this cell. I think it's good. I'm not entirely sure. Yep, good cell. Okay, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to try and arc these two without really sticking things on the battery. I really could if I wanted to, but I don't actually want to. So fold these up so this way I can stick them exactly where I want them. Little test leads. Wish I had actual test leads. That'd be nice, but yeah. Crazy guy in the basement. That goes there. That goes there. No, that does not go there. Red goes on the other side. Yeah. So, that there, that there. I know I have a connection now, and now I don't. So that was probably my mistake. Okay, red light, and walk these together. No green light. Though something got hot, that was fun. I fucked this LED. That'd be funny. Oh, there was no red light while I was testing it. Then you fold it back. Oh, look, it's a fucking short circuit. Cool. Oh, I should have. Okay. Could give that a break for a second. It's getting warm. Because I'm running the one LED off of it straight. Alright, that's enough playing. That is actually quite enough playing. Snippy, snippy. Snippy, snippy, strippy, strippy. And instead of, oh yeah, I'll use the multi-tool to strip it. Yeah, I'm recording 60 frames a second, but my secondary camera is definitely not 60 frames a second. Okay, that one. That soldering iron. Yeah, I mean, all of the guys that do this and make lots of money out of it. EEV blog actually pulled the curtain back and showed how much he made of makes from YouTube to the point where he does it for friggin' his job, which is pretty cool. This iron sucks my nuts. See? Oh God, ew. What the hell do I have on there? It's burning. Just smells like fucking rancid poo. There. The tip will now melt things. I'm doing this all real time, all one shot. Which is why the damn video is so long. Because the iron that I'm using is a piece of shit. And doesn't like to melt things. I see the blob of solder on the tip here. It's all fucking burnt to shit and all that. Because it takes forever to get the edge hot. Or even the very tip. There. Good enough for me. I got that one, and get see us at, let's say, ground. And watch, this has come off. Yep, that's come off. Hooray. I need a small tip so I could see. Instead of just fucking doing the blinking thing and. There. But now, of course, I've got to check and make sure I didn't short anything. Just attaching that stupid little wire. And I did short something. I'm gonna try and break it off. And probably take the resistor with it. What do you guys think? Taking the resistor with it? Unorthodox methods. No, I think that's fine. Put 12 volts into it, see if it fucking blows up. Alrighty. But that one is attached. This other one is a pain in my nuts. That resistor. I have not mapped out this board, so I have no idea what half the shit does. Nor will I pretend to know what half the shit fucking does. But what it will do is... smells like fucking piss. Put some more fucking solder on there. Because the lead-free solder blows. Yeah, look at that. The lead-free solder does not like... or the leaded solder does not like the lead-free solder. Tells it to go right the fuck off. And give me a little white wire. Tinny tin tin tin. And zip. There goes the other fucking wire. But this one's attached now. Adventures in fuckery. I have a feeling that I'm going to be investing in plastic dip. Because I use so goddamn much of it. So it's quiet down here. I'm happy. There we go, short solved. And... yeah, for you, for the motherfucker. For those of you yelling at your screens, what the fuck is this moron doing? It's fucking it up. Yes, of course I am fucking it up bad. But, all in the name of science. And all in the name of I'm playing with shit. Oh, almost had it. Almost had a good connection there. Get in there. There we go. And now I'm shortened to that fucking resistor. There we go. We are clear of that resistor. Good deal. So now, when I take my light, it will do absolutely nothing. Take my battery, and it will do absolutely nothing. Because the... fucking LED is not soldered. Well, that's fixable. No, it's... no. No, I missed on the one side. Not got enough solder on there. Fucking tap it and flow it, and it'll be good. Tap, flow. Go with the flow, man. Go with the fuck you. All right, see, I'm working on this tiny little piece right here. Let's see if I can center it. pop the zoom up a little bit so you guys can see. Autofocus, I've just given up on it, so. Okay, well, we can try the, let's try the coin cell again. Try lighting this bad boy up. See what color he is. If I got the right color. That'd be funny. And any luck, it'll go pop. Nope. Okay, so this is the way it should be working. Do we see anything? Do we see any light? Do we have any light? Do we have any light? No, we do not. Wrong finger in the way. Nope. We have no light. 3-volt cell. I know it's a good cell. So, we need to pull that. Wiggle, 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 and pull that. And then we go just straight to the fucking source. And we solder our test leads there. Oops, by a capacitor. Well, hopefully I get what's on my Amazon wish list. And I actually am going to put that in the description here. So this way you wonderful people can get me things that I will enjoy from my Amazon wish list, and they will in turn help me to make better videos and maybe even more stuff. You know, I've got a Weller soldering station on there. Don't tell my wife, but I think she got it for me for the weekend holiday of Yule, which I've been celebrating the last month. Don't tell her. Okay, so let's use that other small little side, because this one side's fucked. The insulation's all melted and ghetto and shit. This thing is making it most horrendous. The absolutely most horrendous 60 hertz buzz in my left ear. And it is driving me mad. And you guys, of course, can't hear it, which is good. See, let's do that. Because I do not wish to be hassled about where I work. I just came home from work and decided, you know, I'm going to make this video. Oh, what that was, let's get it back down here. I went and took my pliers, my little Neil-nose multi-tool pliers. I grabbed the wire, and I just spun in one direction, which tightened it up. And there goes more paint. Oh, man. Tin again. And there's a solder boogie on the wall. But it does not smell of paint anymore. I'm le happies. Le happies. Tin tin tin. Just with what's on the soldering iron. Because I just need to tack it. I don't need to make a good fucking 20-year joint. Just need to tack it. And I smell wood and paint and ick as this thing heats up. You must be part of the heatening. I mean, although I probably did nuke this LED with heat. Yeah, you never know. It'd be fun. It'd be neat if I did. And hot air station would be nice. But this is all because I wanted to make the fucking little light inside green. Instead of white. And you know what? I've got my reasons for doing shit. Okay, fuck it. I'm just going to tin this. Oh, and I missed it with the camera. That's a pretty tinning. And zip. Zip. Motherfucker, zip. It's not that I'm bad at this. It's just got bad tools. If I hook the wires up to this and it works, well, you know what? Give me this. And give me the fucking SMD. Come here. Oopsie. I just... Oh. Well, it's not working now. I just fucking broke the package. Yeah, that ain't working now. Oh well. Screw it. Oh, sometimes you win some, sometimes you lose some. And I'm about. ...75 minutes in, and I done went and fucked this up real good. So fuck it. Bye bye. And come here, you hot piece of shit. Now, that is what we did not want to happen, and that's for the SMD to get all fucked up. But it got fucked up, and that's okay. Because that was super gay. That's alright. The legs will be tinned for next time. So that's why I just laid across, heat the legs, and be fucking done. There. So, those legs are tinned. And there's a piece of SMD on there, and SMD on the wall. Yep, that is actually why I've rotated my desk. So this way, as I'm soldering or doing whatever, I can just fling shit onto the wall over there, and then it becomes art. You know, like right here. Oh, you can't see it. It's just off camera. Oh, well. Oh, right there, there's about 3 or 4 blobs of solder. And they are. Let's see if I can get one right there. They are there from various other projects I've done. And, yeah, it's nice to be able to make art out of crap. And there goes that big old blob right there. Blobs of hot molten metal everywhere! And on me. So, that'd be the end of this one. I'm gonna end this video in failure. Failure to change the fucking LED light. How sad is that? Although, I was using an SMD light from this stupid little dollar store. Little flashy thingy. There we go. Which, I think the SMD was fucked the second it came off. Because, you know, I let my son play with this one. Because he wanted to. The LED I was playing with came off of right here. Over. Down. Came off of right there. And my finger's in the way. There we go. Three, two, one, fuck. There you go. I find if I curse at my phone, it focuses. So those two little pads right there we see, are where the LED I was playing with came from. And now I don't need to focus for this, but this is the back of the board. Scorched to fuck. So it may have been toast before I even played with it, but we'll never know. I'm curious though to see if this board works after my son got into it, because he wants to learn the art. And yep, that's cool. That makes me happy. But nope, board does not work. Nope. That's cute. That still should do the do. No, that doesn't work. Okay, off to the trash box with you. This board's toast. So. Hey, bud, what's up? Well, it's going for a couple days there, buddy. Maybe I was doing it backwards. Maybe they have negative marked as positive, positive marked as negative. And I'm just a Nimrod. I'm just a Nimrod. No. Nope. So that board, I mean, there's two reds and a blue LED I can get off of here. If I really want it to. You know what? I am actually going to change that out for a red. But I'm going to take a break here. And that's going to be the video for right now. And just record it in OBS, you know, and just played with, thrown together. So I will start a new video when I go to remove the service mount LED. I'll remove one of the red ones. That'll be fun. Until next time. Which will probably be tomorrow, day after. It all depends on what I'm doing that day.